How do I stop spam? You can't, but don't run away. Hi everyone, I'm Leo Notenboom for askleo.com. It's true, you cannot stop spam. Spam is inevitable. But there are things you can do to reduce the amount of spam you get and deal with the spam you will get. Here are some thoughts. First, never, ever respond or act on spam. Now, of course, I'm saying don't buy whatever the spammer is trying to sell you. That's kind of an obvious thing, although some people do that too. No, what I'm saying is don't click on any links. Don't respond to the email. Don't try to unsubscribe from it, which will actually be a separate point here in a minute. The point here is that anytime you interact with spam, it can be detected by the spammer, and as a result, they send you more spam. Remember, they're sending out millions of pieces of spam every day to email addresses that, for the most part, probably aren't even legitimate. So every time they find someone who responds to their email or who tries to unsubscribe, they know that whatever email address they just sent that to is a real email address that's read by a real person. The way I put it, we got us a live one. You're going to get more spam. Unsubscribe is also very important to call out separately, because in our fight to reduce spam, it is so tempting to click on the unsubscribe link that the spammer will have helpfully put at the bottom of their message. The problem is, it's not an unsubscribe link. Effectively, it's a give me more spam link. Because again, this link, by clicking on it, tells the spammer that you read your email, that you are someone that actually reads the email, interacts with the spam, and therefore is a target worthy of getting more spam. Never unsubscribe from spam. Don't enable images on spam. In theory, it's fine to look at spam. Go ahead and look at spam, you know, see what's in your spam folder. That's fine. But never enable images. Why? Same thing. The act of displaying an image typically causes the image file to be fetched from a location that the spammer can notice. As a result, same thing. We've got us a live one. This person has seen our spam. They've looked at our images. Therefore, they should get more spam. That's why images are disabled by default. Don't give your email address to the wrong person. This happens, I'll just say, often enough that it's a problem. It's not uncommon for us to fill in our email address on an online form or something. If you have to do that, consider using a throwaway email address, a temporary email address, an email address for an account that isn't your primary account, that you honestly don't care if it gets full of spam because it's not what you use anything for. Save your main email address only for those people, organizations, and businesses that you trust and know. Everybody else, give them some other email address. If you need to interact with them, even if for a short time, sure, make it an email address that actually works. But don't make it your primary email address because, again, sometimes, be it marketing, be it theft, or be it something else, your email address can then fall into the hands of a spammer. In that same vein, don't post your email address publicly. This one, I don't know, it confuses me. On Ask Leo, if you leave a comment, above the comment box it says, don't post any personal information. Don't post your email address. And yet, every other day or so, I or one of my assistants has to go in and clean out the email addresses that people have posted publicly. Why is this an issue? Again, spammers look wherever they can for email addresses. And by having an email address posted in a public place, there's a very good chance that a spammer will come along and say, hey, That looks like an email address. I will add it to my list of people to send spam to. Don't. If you need to send your email address to someone, do it in a way that isn't public. Do it by email. Do it by messenger. Do it by some other means that doesn't include showing your email address to the entire world. Same vein, trim email before you forward it. This is something that, for some reason, people find very difficult to do. The canonical example is humor, right? You get a piece of humor from someone and you want to forward it on to your friends. If you just hit forward, what happens is that email, the original email that you received, becomes the body of the message you're about to send. And it includes everybody on the to line and the CC line. You've probably seen them. Email that starts with a to line and a from line and a gazillion different email addresses for people you have no idea who they are. The problem, of course, is that, well, you're spreading those people's email addresses, A, without their permission, and B, possibly to locations that you're not even aware of, because your friends can forward and their friends can forward and forward and forward and forward till eventually, yeah, it's not uncommon for that email to land in the hands of a spammer who then harvests all of the email addresses in that message because everybody forwarded without trimming. What do I mean by trimming? When you forward an email, take a moment and delete that information. The header, the to and the from and the subject and the date and all that kind of stuff, followed by the actual content of the message. Delete the header, save the content, and then hit send. And finally, in that same vein, you know you've got that friend. You know you have that person who, no matter what you tell them, they will never trim their mail. They will always forward it on to dozens, if not hundreds of other people. If you know you've got that friend who is going to continually make your email address public, avoid sending email to them. Because once you send email, it's out of your control. Your friend can do anything they want with it. And if you don't trust them to treat your email address properly, the only solution is to not send to them in the first place. Those are steps that will reduce the amount of spam you get. As always, the thing to do when you do get spam, mark it as spam. If spam is showing up in your spam folder, that's the system working as intended. That's okay. Spam in your inbox, mark it as spam. That way the system will presumably learn what spam looks like, especially spam looks like to you, and do a better job of filtering spam into your spam folder automatically in the future. The best offense when it comes to spam, unfortunately, is a strong defense, and that means doing all of the things you can to reduce, but not eliminate, the amount of spam you can get. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/161851. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.